and I'm the assistant band director here at Oliver Springs High School in Oliver Springs, Tennessee. We're located approximately 35 minutes west of Knoxville in the mountains of East Tennessee and have a student body that consists of roughly 400 students. My main job as the assistant director is percussion arranging, instruction, and praying that our equipment holds up for just one more day.
Every other Drumline has so much more stuff than we do.
Every piece of equipment we own is at least 12 years old, and all of the marching equipment and carriers are older than the people who are playing them. We receive no funding from the school or school system, so every dollar we spend on buses, music, instrument repair, etc., comes from selling ad space on our trailer, basketball concession stand profits, and student fundraising.
What about a candy bar?
Even with our lack of funding, we still produce quality students, such as drumline captain and 2014 valedictorian Brianna Wilson, 2014 section leader Stevie Alcorn, who will graduate at least as salutatorian, as well as many others who have received numerous scholarships, served our country in the military, and have gone on to receive degrees and postgraduate degrees. Students are being shunned by their peers, including band students, because of their terrible equipment. Even the band director doesn't want to be seen as or associated publicly with the drumline.
Yes, I am the band director, and our percussion section is phenomenal, but I don't know how they do what they do with those drums. They get phenomenal results, which is a phenomenal feat considering that equipment that they're playing on.
Is it true that you're embarrassed to be seen with the drumline?
Well, not completely, but as individuals, they're phenomenal people. But when they're using that equipment, no way. I mean, I've got an image to uphold, and when they're seen with that equipment, not a good idea.
First place percussion, Oliver Springs.
Woo-hoo! Oh, they're getting better though each time they do.
Mr. Hicks says that if we fall, that we need to save the drum, that we can afford new drummers, but we can't afford new drums.
In closing, here's a little bit more about our group and a look into the secret life of drummers who are looked down upon because of their subpar equipment.
Hey, look, it's cracked.
Drums don't even match.
What'd you do?
Right. Even our equipment has problems.
Even my baby from last year has a crack.
drummer.
Hey guys, what's going on? So,
Hello?
It's always because of the drums.
What does anybody love us?
Opie?
Jordan?
Opie?
Jordan?
Opie!
Jordan!
Opie!
Hey, Shouty!
Don't Shouty me with those drums.
Hey, Taylor. You wanna go out with me?
Those drums? No way.
Just because of the drums. It's always because of the drums.
Gary? What are you doing?
You want to be in the drum line?
Not with those drums.
As a final thought, we have a great program that teaches kids skills that go far beyond music and marching and creates lasting memories. But we just don't have the money to purchase new equipment.
Please.
Our kids take great care of the equipment we have, but the pain, heartache, and rejection they experience because of their drums, that's real. Please help us out and stop this senseless hurting of drummers.
Nobody told me we were making a video.